Greetings everyone and welcome back to the Warlock of the Firetop Mountain game, which beats my ass quite heavily. And so to say, let's put it that way, that the spirit of the adventure is not fucking very kind for us lately. But let's shall not give up yet, right? I mean, you know, just learn to enjoy the failures. It's simple. Simple as that. We pass it and enter the domain of the dead. You reach the end of the path. A strange stone pillar decorated with monstrous bones supports the room. There are paths leading to the left and to the right, and wooden ladder to the left of the stone pillar leads upwards. So we have quite a choice here. Quite a choice indeed. Oh! There is like fucking red souls or some shit there. Let's not take the right one. Well, I don't know. Jesus. This clearly is a bad decision. Like, if you would be zoomed like that, you wouldn't know. Can I see something on the other side? I see some bones. A dead bones, yes. A dead dog, maybe? Look how big is this place. The tower is bullshit, I remember that much. There's another tower from this side. Huh. I honestly don't think there is a good option here. I mean, the ladder is kind of cheeky. I think maybe the ladder? Let's skip the ladder. You climb the ladder, which leads to a trapdoor. You give it a half clamber, though, then hear it slam down behind you. The room is about 8 meters square with another ladder on the far wall. The room is filled with zombies. Of course it is. But of course it is. Of course it is filled with zombies. How much do you understand by filled with zombies, by the way, game? Because I see two. That time I see two skeletons, it was 5 of them. Oh, I should go left, shouldn't I? Maybe I should go right, because it's just a fake, weird place. I don't know. Standing motionless in the center of the room are 4 men. At least they appear to be men. Their skin is a greeny-gray color. Their clothes are tattered and torn, and they are all staring vacantly at the ceiling. One carries a club, one a scythe, one an axe and one a pick. They are ignoring you. Completely. Zombies. I really don't like zombies. Look at this one. This one is fucking... Yeah, that one is happy. Hey, look, there is another one. Yeah, that's the one that's like, okay. Greetings! Around the room are various peasant-style weapons, such as pitchforks, axe handles, and pointed sticks. Several barrels are scattered around the room, and there is another ladder in the far corner. On the northeast corner is a human corpse with a sword in one hand and shield in another. Well, that might as well be another zombie. I mean, you know? Oh, look, I could think potion of invisibility again. That would fucking work it better, probably. Yes, of course it would, because if I didn't use the fucking potion to get the keys to get to the room in which there wasn't anything interesting in it, and then lose all my goddamn provisions, Jesus Christ. Okay, there was 5 gold, that wasn't worth it. That wasn't worth it. Okay. Let's charge them with my... I mean, they are... I don't know, game. You fuck me over the gal is what I do. I know you now. I know you. We have a relationship now, game. You know? I know what. I know. Yeah, I know your tricks. You won't let me just run past them. I might that way just run towards the ladder anyways, though. I mean, they're gonna attack me. I might have a skill check at best. Luck check. Which I'm gonna file and... Okay, let's just... The four men steer into action and shamble towards you. Their weapons ready. You start to scramble back to the trapdoor, but you do not know if you can make it. Your foot slips on a loose pebble and you fall to the ground. But of course I do. Before you can regain your footing, the creatures are upon you. The zombies shuffle towards you slowly, but relentlessly. Their vacant eyes suggest that their actions are controlled by a will which is not their own. You must act quickly. The first zombie reaches you and prepares to swing his club. At least there is... Oh look, there is the dead one. Of course it's a zombie. Look at that shit. Told you it would be. I'm gonna die here again. That's what's gonna happen, isn't it? That's where everything goes to shit. Oh wow! Honestly, you really would thought I would step right where he wants, where he was, wouldn't you? Got 4 stamina left. I'm gonna lose my shit if I die again. For stamina left. I don't know, I don't think I can finish the game. I'm just stuck at it, I think. The poor wretch is lying dead at your feet. Almost look happy to be relieved of the burden of life. But as you look down at them, you sense that you are not the only one to know of their deaths. Oh, to luck! Thank you. Jesus, how about stamina? How about food? How about stop fucking me over? Okay, investigate the weapons lying around. And that doubtly will be anything better. You find nothing remarkable about the weapons. In fact, not a single weapon looks more useful than your own. As you search the depths, you hear a deep thumping from the north, followed by a scream, which sends a shiver down your spine. You have entered a large, circular chamber. The most striking feature here is a large stone bowl that's filled with dark, rich red liquid, which is bubbling. vigorously. Aside from his mysterious-looking pool, there is also a spiral staircase heading the pool and two doorways opposite each other. I want to drink. A chalice would be useful. This? Is this what you want to fucking... Oh my goodness, what the fuck is happening there? This, like, whoa. That's a bad place to be. It's clearly a bad place to be. Why would you want to drink this weird thing? Okay. In the other side, I see some faces upstairs. Oh my goodness. The fuck I get into. Jesus. Okay, so it seems like there is a couple of ways you could take. In case you die and I will. Again. I'm not taking this path. Fuck that. I don't know what this is, but I don't want to know. The other one looks kind of safer. I even feel like maybe I should go right. What will you do now? Drink from the pool?
No.
Oh, could you imagine if this actually gave me fucking health back? Probably wouldn't. Let's go to the right doorway. A bench! You enter a large room. Various bits of wood and debris are slowly and silently across the floor. A prominent set of steps lead upwards at the rear of the room, and there are some steps leading down. The room is deathly silent, and neither exit provides clues on where you should go. In the corner is a crude wooden desk with a box on it. Nearby is a wooden bench, suit table for the resting. Resting. First and foremost, resting. My god, if I had my provisions still, I would be so good on my health, there wouldn't be a single problem. Single one. It would be just fine, it would just go up and it would be nice and hanky and dory and whatever. And this box is like clearly a bullshit box probably. Hey. Okay, there is a fucking dead worms up there and... Pictures of Frankenstein? I don't know. And I don't want to go up anymore, actually. That sounds like an awful idea to go up anymore. Oh, because those are like coffins, I see. Is this box containing a key, you think? It will be trapped box as fuck. You approach the desk and open the box. There is a key within the box, which you take. Oh, there you go. Follow steps down. No. Well, if I have to choose down or up, I obviously gonna go up because I'm not fucking doing loop here. Fuck this shit. I just want to go back. Why can't go back here and then go up and... Okay, Jesus. You're just gonna walk past those nasty things, would you? Reaching the top of the steps, you enter into a musty burial chamber. Tombs line the chamber, giving an intense sense of claustrophobia. There are strange carved faces on the wall, whose eyes seem to follow you. Around the room, etched into the wall is a word, Zagor. To the north are more steps that lead upwards. The one side of the chamber, there is an ancient dusty book on a stone plinth. Okay. This must be the Zagor's family crypt. Creepy. Suddenly you feel a rumbling which becomes violent shaking. Bursting through the rock are grotesque reanimated giant worms. Parts of their flesh have decayed and they have been grey, sickly skin. They are crypt worms, revived to protect the resting place of Zagor's ancestors. You draw your weapon and prepare to fight. Fuck. Okay, this looks like more important thing, isn't it? Oh, you son of a... I forgot they doing that shit. Ah! Son of a bitches. Oh, I was so lucky. Okay. Okay. It's all about, like, I think I'm getting better at this point in this combat, but holy shit. With an eerie moan, the crypt ones cease moving and fall to the ground with an earth-shattering crash. You put your weapon away and decide what to do next. You could either examine the book or the leaf before you may encounter some other creature. Well, I would rather to leave, and I don't think there is any book which is particularly good idea to read in this place and time. So probably everything is cursed and some bullshit, and why all they look exactly the same? That's also something I'm questioning slightly. Yeah, but today it's all time I have to recording, so I think that would be just enough moment. Just enough good moment to wrap this episode up. And thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know if you did. My thoughts didn't change much. I think we're gonna die pretty soon. And it will just get worse. And I don't think I'm gonna finish it on first playthrough. Although I can see possibility of going through it again. Maybe cutting up the parts, you know, or stuff I changed on way there. If I like run out of the resurrecting stones, which I have one still. So maybe, I don't know. What do you expect me to know? I don't know this game very well. I don't know it at all, in fact. But I'm enjoying it. I might like sound pissed, but I'm really enjoying it. I think I'm pissed because I'm recording it, and I don't have this flexibility to like just move back or like reload without like losing all my progress, and that's, I think, which is slightly annoying if you record videos. It would be good for a stream, I suppose, or something like that, maybe. I don't know. In any case, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Let me know if you did. The comment section is down below, and I'm gonna see you with more Warlock of the Firetop Mountain next Friday. Have a lovely weekend, guys, and farewell.